Okay guys, in this video I will talk about the use of stiffener in base plate and also about the shape of this base plate. Okay, so before starting the video, if you are new to this channel, please do subscribe and also please don't forget to press the bell icon so that in future you can be benefited. Okay, so let's start today's topic. Before the starting, if you are a beginner, in that case you may be thinking about that what is the stiffener and what is the use of a stiffener. Okay, so if you have any I section as a beam, you know that to prevent the buckling of this wave, we need to use the stiffener, or indirectly you can say we need to strengthen this wave by the use of a plate, and this plate is known as stiffener. Okay, now if you ask me why this wave buckle, you can go to the playlist and there you can watch it. Okay, so similarly in the case of a base plate, if this is the circular column, if this is the load and this is the pedestal, this is the base plate. Okay, so the base plate is, you can see, is quite thinner, and to strengthen this base plate, here you can use this stiffener or the stiffener plate like this. Okay, so this is all about the stiffener in base plate. Now the question is, why you need to know about the use of stiffener in base plate? Okay, so let's understand. Let's say this is the column and this is the point load, here this is the base plate and it is being rested over this pedestal. So what will happen due to this external point load? Simply there will be some upward thrust from this pedestal to this base plate, and you need to design this base plate based on the bending moment produced at this end. How? Well, let's say this is the upward thrust from the pedestal, okay, and it is being acting throughout the base plate, and let's say we are separating only the right portion. Okay, and here the plate is fixed at the face of the column, and now this part is actually acting like a yes cantilever beam. Now what is the bending moment diagram for this cantilever beam under this UDL acting from beneath? Simply this is like this. Okay, zero at the tip and maximum at the face of the column. So if you design this plate, this base plate, based on this maximum bending moment, let's say the thickness requirement is this much, you have to provide this thickness. Okay, and of course this is not at all economical. In that case, what you have to do? Well, you can use this much of plate thickness, okay, and now provide some extra plate like this. Okay, so this is the extra plate you are providing. Okay, now what is the basis of using this particular shape? Okay, so let's say you have used this basic thickness, plate thickness, based on some nominal bending moment here. Okay, now you can see that the bending moment is increasing parabolically. Okay, so if you can use a plate that is also varying parabolically, you are safe. Okay, so here simply use a plate in the shape of a parabola, but the cutting of a parabolic plate is quite difficult. So you can use directly a triangular shape. Okay, the material in the triangular shape is more by this much amount, so you are safe. Got it? So now it is clear to you why this stiffener has been used to this base plate, and also why the shape is triangular. Okay, that's it. If you love this video, don't forget to share it.